anime fans in the entire world. At the top of the marquee stands a pair of veteran heavyweights. It's almost a home game for Josh Barnett, fighting in Japan for the 17th time in his near two-decades-long career. He takes on Roy Nelson and his trademark overhand right, one of the most devastating weapons in the division. The FS1 UFC weigh-in show starts right now. Edition of the UFC weigh-in show from Los Angeles. Karen Bryan here alongside two guys with tons of frequent flyer miles, Brian Stan and Michael Bisping. Caroline Pierce is on location as well. And Brian, thank you for taking the flight to LA rather than Tokyo.
You know you fly a lot when the LA trip for 4 hours is your short trip. It's nice.
Nice to see you. And Michael, of course, you're going to put some miles and go to Australia.
Yeah, that's right. 7 weeks I'll be flying down under, taking on Robert Whittaker. But it's nice to have a night off from the training, from getting punched in the face.
Very nice. Well, folks, let's get right to it. Brian, tell the people about the main event between Josh Barnett and Roy Nelson.
Well, let's kick things off with Josh Barnett. He's one of the all-time greats in the UFC, in the heavyweight division overall in mixed martial arts. And he returns back to Japan, where he is very familiar making this long flight fighting there. A brutal guy everywhere in the sport, a crafty veteran, but he's also very good in the in-between phases. On the ground, he submitted some of the best guys in the world. His ground and pound is fantastic. Where I really think we're going to see him shine in this matchup is inside the clinch, where he is also very, very dangerous.
And of course, he's taking on Roy Big Country Nelson. This is a guy that they say he has good grappling. Apparently, he has a black belt. But I tell you what, you never see it because he's always looking for one thing and one thing only, and that is the knockout. The guy holds the record for absorbing the most strikes. Now, that's not a good thing to be the holder of, but it says one thing. He has a good chin, and he's looking for the knockout all the time.
Both gentlemen are finishers for sure. And Michael, in our co-main event, I know you're going to be watching this one closely. You're still active in the 185 division. We've got Gegard Mousasi and Uriah Hall thrown down.
Yeah, that's right. We've got the promise of Uriah Hall taking on the experience of Mousasi. Mousasi is one of the most experienced in the whole, experienced fighters in the whole of MMA. He's a great boxer, he's a great kickboxer, he's a fantastic wrestler and submission artist. A former Dream champion, Strikeforce champion, he's fought on all the major organizations all over the world. Of course, Uriah Hall, he had the breakout season of The Ultimate Fighter, looked incredible, struggled a little since coming out of The Ultimate Fighter. He's won some, he's lost some by decision, but this for him is a massive opportunity to break into the top 10 and, you know, really make a name in the UFC.
Yeah, a huge jump in competition for Uriah Hall. And for Gegard Mousasi, with all the experience and the former titles that he's had, you know, I feel like we're actually seeing the best Mousasi we've ever seen now. And he even mentioned that this week. He feels like he's finally now poised for a title.
All right. Well, let's get out to Japan with Kenny Florian making his MC debut. Take it away, Ken.
Hello, Japan. I am Kenny Florian, and welcome to UFC Fight Night. Barnett versus Nelson. Here are our lovely UFC Octagon girls, director of talent relations, Sean Shelby, our general manager of UFC Asia, Ken Berger. Our first fight is a welterweight bout between Shinsho Animal